Hey, buddy, it's Victa. It's time to Eat and Run here, the Binding of Isaac Victa Repentance series. Happy Tuesday, Mosh Pit. We did have another video across 3,000 likes now, only 9 away. We're officially in single digits for the like streak goal. Thank you very much for making that possible. And my goodness, the memes and artwork have been blowing up on this Invicta subreddit. Go check it out if you have not already. Here is today's artwork of the day, brought to you by Crummy Crumson. Battle Thread was episode 757, which, by the way, was the worst run of all time. I can't believe you actually did it. You're now officially the most patient man on YouTube. The most patient man on YouTube. I love, like, this sort of, like, jelly bean, like, gummy bear sort of style mixed in with the really heavy metal Sinvicta person skeleton there, along with, of course, Little Sissy. So very talented stuff here. Great artwork. I mean, this type of artwork is so difficult to do. Like, all the artwork is so difficult to do, but particularly this one, really, really enjoyed it. Thank you very much, Crummy, and everyone who upvoted that one. Let's hop on in and see what we got going on. Oh, boy. We have Ipecac and the broken gas blast cannon. 9 golf Delta 2, Alpha Delta Kilo 6. Now, oh my gosh, and our range is absolute garbage, along with our shot speed. This is not good. Especially with us having the glass cannon, we don't necessarily, and on top of that, we don't know exactly how much HP we have. Yeah, this is gonna get dangerous real quick. Obviously, we have a ton of damage thanks to Ipecac, and we have unlimited amounts of bombs, but the problem is going to be glass cannon here, and thankfully, we did find a fully charged glass cannon, well, a double charge there. So we are able to charge glass cannon. Not that it really matters anyway, because we still have an Ipecac tier, which we probably shouldn't be firing with a glass cannon, especially considering like how little range we have. So yeah, and especially without us knowing exactly how much HP we do or do not have, we cannot really take a whole lot of risks right now. Getting the treasure map would be awesome if we could manage to do it. I'm not gonna take any chances with spiders, but yeah, this is about to be spicy, y'all. This is about to be real spicy, because we need to be able to move quickly, and we can't do that even with our, even with, like, you know, if the thing here, okay, here's the thing with Ipecac is that you represent the biggest danger to yourself. Thought maybe it'd be there. And on top of that, with the glass cannon, that's going to give you a really high chance of hurting yourself even more, which we don't really want to do until, I mean, you don't really want to do a period, but especially since we don't know how much HP we've got. So looking for the super secret room, which is right there, and the hearts are going to be kind of useless. I really, 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 really want to get the treasure map. Now, here's another thing that I'm kind of peeved about right now is the fact that, like, our item room was so small that we couldn't, either the game refused to spawn us a reroll pedestal with us having pay to win, or it just didn't count for the first floor, which is probably the more likely of the two. And I'm going to be even more upset if we end up not getting this map because we're short 1 cent. Thank you, Cardio Coin. Thank you for saving everyone here for the next, like, 2 minutes of me incessantly complaining about not having 1 cent to get the treasure map. I'm sure everyone is very happy for you. No more so than me, because I really, really, really wanted the treasure map. And the reason why is obviously because we need to know where to go, but also because we need to get out of the glass cannon range as fast as possible, meaning that we need to get a spacebar item. I'm going to hold on to this money for now, because we do have pay to win, and that is going to guarantee us a reroll pedestal inside of every single item room until we get rid of it. So, yeah, but this is a spicy start, very dangerous. We have Curse in the Unknown again. So that's fun. And before any of you ask, am I going to use glass cannon? No, not with this range and Ipecac. That is a, you are literally asking for it if you do that. And I'm not going to be doing that. Okay, maybe you're not literally asking for it, but you're asking for it. I'm not gonna do it. I think that is a very bad idea. It does look like we're able to No, I don't know if the secret room's going to be here or not. Need to find a soul heart. Yeah, that's not going to do it. Soul converter, I mean, it's better than glass cannon. So I'm going to get rid of glass cannon. I have no idea what our HP is, obviously. But not having glass cannon here with us having Ipecac and very, very short range and not great shot speed is a win. That's already good. So we don't have to worry about ourselves dying anyway, at least not from our not by our way. Now, the game can still easily kill us because obviously Ipecac with this range is going to be kind of tedious and kind of scary. But we shall persevere, as we always do. Get a golden bomb here, which is pretty much useless because we already have unlimited explosions. Right there, again, I have no idea what our HP is, so no way to tell if that was actually going to be lethal damage or not. Now, I will say that whenever you have glass cannon, you don't have to worry about dying in one hit. That's something that they limited, which was news to me when I first we did all those glass cannon runs. And I'm not looking to try to start it again here, although we do get the quota. Of course, we're still trying to look for a key because I would love to get into our item room so we can start re-rolling and possibly get some of that HP. I saw that super jump coming a mile away, game. Don't even try. I don't know where the secret room currently is. There it is. Going to be a keeper, which I'm just going to do that. All right. Well, still don't have a key. We know that we're not on a half heart because, we'd see a little pee puddle on the at the start of a room, I should say. No dice there on a key, and we get an eternal heart, which we pretty much have to take. But the consequence here is that we're not going to be able to take a devil deal because we just flat out don't know how much HP we have or don't have. That's what happens when you get back-to-back Curse of the Blinds and our, Sinvicta. Yeah, well, we get HP now, but I think angel deals are going to be better here just because, again, given the fact that we have no idea... We have no idea how much HP we have. We don't need offense. We've already got the offense. It's baked into what we've got now. But it's a real, real shame that we are not going to be able to get into our item room. And we can't even go into the curse room, really, because, again, we don't know how much HP we have. So, yeah. And, I mean, the likelihood of us finding a key inside of there is probably not good either. So, yeah. Just skip an item room. Hey, look at that. We had we were down to one and a half soul hearts. So, yeah. But going to last week's question of the episode, that one was the Kidney Tech episode, where I asked, what is your favorite carry support item? And it was a very loose definition on what a carry support item was, and a lot of people really ran with it. We had 100, at the time of this recording, we had over 130 replies to it, which is one of our most talked about subjects ever on the new engagement initiative that we started a couple weeks ago. So thank you very much, everyone who replied to that. Again, the most upvoted comments will be read and talked about a little bit here in our canonical episodes. And everyone's been really, really doing a great job supporting the channel with that. The most upvoted comment on that thread was from Burning Knight, who said, "This might be a hot take, but I think that Shielded Tears is real good. And while it can be annoying with low tears rate, if you get some Claudies going in there, it will be zero tears getting close to you." That is true. And we already pretty much showed what happens whenever you get piercing shots and shielded tears. We showed that against Hush in the on Sunday's run. Is it a carry support item? I wouldn't necessarily... Me, personally, I wouldn't consider shielded tears to be a carry support item. It's definitely a support item for sure. No one's going to argue with that. But a carry support... I think is a little bit that's a little bit generous. Stars. And we'll take Undefined just because it's just better than the Soul Converter. Resack, nah. We need stats here. We need HP. We need movement speed. And we do not want Spoonbender. Spoonbender plus go Metronome. I think we go Metronome. We're doing stuff today. It may not be smart stuff, but we're doing stuff. But yeah, Shielded Tears being a carry support item, I think that's a little generous on the definition. It's still very good though. We demonstrated that on the Tainted Keeper run that we did on Sunday. So I'm with you halfway there, Burning Knight. And again, thank you very much for the comment. As I hit myself while I'm trying to read the next comment, which was submitted by RonnieJ02, who said, "If Sacred Orb counts, that's my favorite support item. I would consider it a carry support item for sure." You know, it's not one that has a direct influence on what you're doing in the game. It doesn't have like an active ability. It doesn't have like a tier effect associated with it or anything like that. But it definitely does change the outcome for pretty much like universally positive ways in universally positive ways for your run. So by that definition, yeah, carry support item, absolutely. And Sacred Orb, of course, is fantastic. Like, it is so, so strong. Everyone knows that if you get Sacred Orb, you're going to be taken care of for the rest of the run. And that's really what it's all about. I have no idea where the secret room is. We found the super secret room. I'm honestly shocked that the regular secret room is not below the shop. So that means it's either Catty Corner over here or it's in a very odd spot. That would definitely constitute as a very odd spot. We get double keys there from the slot machine, and we get absolutely nothing in here. All right. Well, I'm not gonna open up the golden chest inside the boss trap room or mob trap room unless we had a way to teleport out of there, which we didn't at the time when I had the stars card. But yeah, Sacred Orb, absolutely. I totally agree with that. That would be a carry support item in my opinion. Maybe not an active carry support item like, say, Tech Point 5 would be, but it's good enough for sure. Definitely to warrant discussion anyway. And finally, MattyJ8299 said Rock Bottom because it's best for no stat downs. And yeah, that Rock Bottom, 100% carry support item. That is the carry support item I think that people need to be talking about. Got a world card here, and the world card is, it's useful up to a certain extent, but obviously we don't need it to show us where the secret rooms are, because, I mean, we're eventually going to find them anyway. See Spider Mod showing us the HP bars of everything. Spider saving the access to the curse room momentarily anyway. There we go. Get a golden key, very nice. Metronome, and hey, look, there we go. Metronome giving us a soul heart there because we ended up drawing a latch key. Now Metronome is kind of dangerous because it can draw from some pretty gnarly pools. It can draw rerolls, I believe. Anyway, it can draw. I think it can draw missing. No, I think. But there's a lot of stuff that it also can't draw from. By draw, I mean like pull from. So Metronome will do essentially a random item. No, we can't take Montezuma's. As much as I would love to, we just can't. Unless we had Explosive and Mutiny. It's going to do a random item every time we use it. And we do gain the item's benefit. So if we end up drawing like, say, Raw Liver, we end up keeping the 2 HP, which is great. It's what inspired the Metronome and then eventually the Let Me Get Down challenge that we had for Wacky Wednesday before it's taken a sort of hiatus here. And people are still asking me about Wacky Wednesday. Is it going to be back this week? Is it not? What are we going to end up doing? It's definitely not coming back this week. Maybe next week. Hey, look at that. We got ourselves an HP upgrade. Maybe next week. I think that a lot of people were pretty adamant about being happy that we're just getting straight up Eden runs for a while, and you know, it's just the gift that keeps on giving, because no matter what, I didn't actually mean to lay a bomb there. Yeah, I mean, people just love the Eden runs. I mean, that's you know, at the risk of being a one-trick pony that I've talked about many times now, like, it's still what people really come to enjoy from the channel. And you know, I'm not going to to deny people of that, especially, I mean, like, it does get a little bit irritating. Not irritating. It gets a little challenging for me to come up with interesting or cool or neat ideas for Wacky Wednesday. And I don't ever really want to try to force stuff. And that kind of extends to making sure that the videos are entertaining for people and are giving, like, it's just like, you know, it's just a good time. Like, that's what people really watch these videos for, is for the commentary, something to listen to, occasionally learn something about Isaac. And, you know, Eden runs are, they definitely provide the best vessel to do that with. But at the same time, you know, changing stuff up every now and then doesn't hurt. And, you know, Wacky Wednesdays was not even supposed to be a thing. It was just going to be like a, yeah, you know, we're like, let's do a crazy mod. And then, you know, and then the first Wacky Wednesday was very popular. We've had a couple of really popular Wacky Wednesdays. But at the same time, people like to maintain the status quo and make sure that we're getting our Eden runs in. And I'm happy to oblige for a little bit, a little while. Maybe take like a whole month off of it, and we'll see where the we'll see where the recharge tank is going to be. Is going to be at whenever we do finally get to, that was the broken shovel, but that would stop the feet from coming down. Never mind. Anyway. But yeah, rock bottom for sure. Absolutely. Rock bottom, hard carry, support item. Everyone knows rock bottom. Everyone loves rock bottom. Some people don't like rock bottom just because, like, it's just an auto win, but there are going to be items that are just auto wins. We absolutely need this range upgrade and movement speed. So that's a big, big time upgrade for us. I'm not going to take 7 seals. And this, the range upgrade's already improving everything here. Even though we just hit ourselves. So E6? Maybe. It was a great reaction to see people's reaction to the TM trainer run, the worst run of all time. I really don't think that was a stretch. I truly don't. Like, I honestly think that run was the worst run of all time. For a great majority of that run. And that's one of those runs. I said it even during the episode when I was recording. I said, you know, just imagine if we actually win this run. Like, the idea of winning a run that bad with what we had to work with seemed just unobtainable. There's no way that, like, I was prepared to see us win through that run. I was for sure, this is it. This is going to be it. Like, this is done. You know, we're going to go back to random streaking, and then after random streaking, it goes right back to Eden streaking. I mean, that's just, you know, that's just how it goes. And I was sort of, like, prepared for it. Like, I was, like, I wasn't ready for it, but, like, if it happened, it happened. And, of course, it would happen, and I think that it will eventually end on something like a TM trainer run where it's just out of my control, and there's just, like, just there's no, oh my, this is a bad idea. I'm gonna do it, but it's a bad idea. Oh, he's right there. Okay. Oh boy. Sumptorium, little Claudies with Ipecac. Yeesh. No, we do not want Continuum. We want range. We don't want that kind of range. Mud equals power. Is it me or did that machine not make an explosion sound? Because I didn't hear one. Plus, I was just talking with my big stupid voice, and didn't hear it, but yeah, this is a bad idea. I'm gonna do it, but it's a bad idea. I don't like this room at all. So Sumptorium, here we go again. We have a artillery line of just firing. I mean, we're just shelling everything here. This is gonna get ugly in a very, very quick hurry here. We do need to be careful about our HP consumption, obviously. This is one of the few times with Sumptorium we are going to have to learn how to balance our usage. It's not something I say lightly, because obviously it's Sumptorium, and it's one of the best items in the game, period. But this is one of those few times where we're going to have to be like, okay, let's settle down with the Sumptorium. We don't want to end up killing ourselves because we use too much hearts, and then we end up hitting ourselves with the Ipecac. At the same time, though, whenever we get a red heart, But soul hearts, yeah. And there go all of our bodies, 2-2-1 spider. Excuse me? There's no way that spider should have lived through any of that. So this now becomes a we don't care about items run, we only care about HP run. So hearts, what we're looking for here. We actually have a chance to make boss rush, not that it really matters a whole lot, because like, you know, there's not many items in the boss rush pool that we truly are going to be looking for. Unicorn stump is, it's good, but it ain't Sumptorium good. Bro, what are with these trash item rerolls? We've had some pretty hellacious rolls. Lottie just took himself out there. Yeah, we need to hurry. We can come back for the vault. Don't worry. We're gonna come back. Right now, the priority is to get to boss rush and get our Clotties back. Blow that up just so we can get our Angel Deal, hopefully. Really hate that enemies cause contact damage and stuff on our Clotties, but now, against my better judgment, I am going to go to Lamb. I say against my better judgment because this is not really smart. Oh, man. Do we dare take Tech X Ipecac with Sumptorium? This is going to be interesting. Now, it's still, as you just see right there, it still is going to explode. So this is not necessarily the safest maneuver, but at least it stops the travel time of our tears. going from point A to point B. That being said, though, we can still absolutely hurt ourselves and do more than that if we're not careful. And we do have money equals power. HP upgrade, which is good. It does suck that we lost so much damage taking Tech X, but I do think it's a small price to pay for what is going to be essentially just an amazingly powerful item. A powerful combo here with Sumptorium and everything. A little baggy. I'm actually pretty glad that we missed the donation machine there. So we got Virgo, by the way, which is going to give us neutral or positive pills. There we go. So we got a nice little almost full heal thanks to that two of hearts, which doubles the amount of current red hearts that you have. And that's going to buy us some more bodies. Now here, it's actually a little bit better for us because we don't have to worry about the Clotties hurting themselves on Ipecac shots. And that's kind of the big thing that they were suffering from, other than walking into things, of course, was getting hit by their own Ipecac shots. And we don't have to worry about that anymore as long as we're not staying next to a rock. Now, if we end up getting some some shielded tears out of this, hey, we gonna be in business. I mean, we're already in business. Like, we're right now, we're kind of like capitalizing on the market share and My God, that pin was out of nowhere. And I had no idea there was a pin in this room. There we go. The heart means more clots for us. Now, I will admit, even though I am a simp for Sumptorium, there are some grumblings in the community about Sumptorium being kind of too broken, too boring, overpowered, yada, yada, yada. You know how it goes. Because it's like an automatic win. But, I mean, if you just saw what we just did to Loki 2, how can you argue with that, you know? Experimental pill. I freaking knew that was going to happen as soon as I took it. I said, this is going to be telepills. Oh, well, we didn't lose our devil deal, so. 9 lives and Demon Baby. So I'm going to take Demon Baby just because, like, we're about to take 9 lives anyway. Let's get rid of our hearts. Well, we've gotten rid of the last ones. This is fine. We get 9 lives, just an extra little bit of some, just insurance. Telepills. Taking that golden pill there. But Sumptorium is just the definition of power overwhelming in Isaac. It is a cheat code. If you have Sumptorium, you're going to win. Especially if you combine it with Tech X and freaking Ipecac. Like, we don't need to worry about our HP now, because we got 9 freaking lives. We might even get to the point where we don't even want to make any more clots, because we just can't afford to do it anymore. Like, not afford to do it, but I mean, like, we're going to be capped. I mean, there's nothing that's going to get close to us at all. Sort of an extension of what we were talking about yesterday, or was it may have been the day before, I don't remember. You know, talking about how awesome it was to see, you know, to see someone who was like a coin shop owner, for me just simply mentioning that, like, hey, like, I wanted to collect coins and, you know, and that sort of stuff. Even more surprising, and even, I don't want to say cooler, but even just as surprising and just as cool, was when I was talking about when I went to the casino, I was talking about the Cajun stud poker. One person in the mosh pit claimed to be their actual like dealer, like a casino dealer, and like a table dealer. And I was like, oh my gosh, like there's no limit to how awesome the mosh pit is. Like, just the amount of people just from all walks of life that make up this community is, like, it's truly inspiring and really, really awesome. And it's like, of course, there's someone who is an actual professional card table dealer at a casino, like, who watches me, and they just so happen to chime in on, you know, how cool it was that there's, like, a bunch of variants and stuff that I play for table games. I actually don't really like table games that much, because I think they're kind of a scam. But, you know, in light doses, they're fun. They are enjoyable to me in light doses. I'd much rather play, like, skill-based games. Poker is my jam. Like, poker will always be my jam. This is just an artillery shelling. Fortunately, I don't have any shielded tiers, so we're going to lose some clotties here. I'm trying to keep him safe as much as I can. Also, not entirely sure why the shots are spreading out like that. Yeah, Hush got absolutely blasted to space and beyond. All right, this is feeling like a Northern Stanley over here. is not nearly as bad as a northern lion. Apparently those Claudies are not affected by brimstone turrets, and that's good. Gas. I don't know why our shots are coming out like that, like in a flying V formation, but I kind of dig it and I kind of don't. I wish they would just stay like uniform. It's going to be through the big room. It pretty much has to be. Big room is right there. I know it is. It is weird how Ipecac and Tech X have this like sort of physics where like it hugs the wall whenever it hits stuff, but yet it's piercing and also spectral. Virgo was a big turn for this run. Bombs are key. We don't really need either. I'm totally honest. One thing I would like to see, though, is more soul hearts. And I'd be wrong again. All right. Surprise, surprise. Invicta doesn't know where he's going. I know. Huge shocker. Yes, I'm being super lazy right now. I am dipping into the soul heart fund a little bit here, but obviously a great, great advantage, because every Claudie that we get is just going to be a Claudie gotten is a Claudie earned. Let's get Bookworm here. Obviously, we're going to stick with Sumptorium because it is the backbone of all of our offense currently. Secret room right there. Should be able to move this heart with a bomb. We'll move it over here, I mean. No, you don't understand. Move it over here. Thank you. It was basically a tinted rock. I don't know why I'm bothered doing that. We have way more power in our shots than any bomb could. It is also kind of weird how the Claudies are facing the opposite direction. Not sure why. Yeah. He didn't even get to spawn one of those bomb flies. If we get Athame on top of this, holy moly. This is going to be ridiculous, because I believe it still maintains the Ipecac properties, I think. It used to do that before the change. And not that it really matters if it does or doesn't now, it's just kind of funny that we're just getting just so ridiculously broken that, like, I don't even know what hit me there. Honestly, I don't care. We'll finish off that soul heart there. There we go. Yeah, that's, it's dead lamb. Second seed is going to be Hotel Quebec 3897 Foxtrot Delta. Man. You know, we weren't sure what kind of run it was going to be whenever we started with Ipecac, especially with such low range and stuff. But now that we've seen it, and it's turned into a Sumptorium run. Sumptorium run, y'all? Yeah. I guess we'll take Sinus Infection. It does work with Tech X. It doesn't... I don't think, anyway, it produces the explosive tears, like, all, like, constantly. Pretty sure it doesn't work like that, but you never know. Pretty sure it doesn't work like that. There you go, get some of our red hearts back. Definitely need it. Mama Mega. Oh, there. Let's dial it back a little bit. Let's go back over here. We don't know what this is. We have Virgo, so it feels like I'm walking on sunshine. Definitely want to get the blanket if possible, as that is going to give us the holy mantle effect whenever we're inside of a boss room, but also give us a soul heart, which is something that we desperately need right now. And we are still looking for 2 cents. And yes, of course, we have money equals power, but it's not really been that important. I don't know if you've noticed anything on this run, but we have not necessarily been short on damage. It's been all gas from the moment we started on this run. No idea where our secret room is. It might be to the north of the cursed room here. I don't think that fit. I don't think that hit. Okay. If it's not there, then it can be here. If it's not there, then it can be here, but we don't need more bombs, so go figure on that. All right. Little Steven, that's why our shots are doing that, because we have conjoined. Did not realize that we had gotten conjoined. So, little Steven, sure. We're not going to be able to get the blanket, that's okay. By using Sumptorium, we could theoretically go into the boss trap room as well. It's probably worth it just because we could get some HP. I almost went down to the next floor. Let's go check it out. We did get our bomb. That is kind of a downside about getting Tech X here, is the fact that, like, it does remove the explosive. It's good and bad, obviously. It's more good than bad, I would say, getting Tech X and Ipecac, because, yes, while it does remove the explosive aspect of Ipecac from doing, like, direct close-range damage, it still is better than the alternative, in my opinion. There's a secret room, which we can go straight into the curse room for. And, once again, curse rooms continue to fail us every step of the way. Shout-out to Pay to Win. Not an item that, not a trinket anyway, that we've been putting a lot of respect on the name. Because we haven't really had to. I mean, we've had a couple rerolls. Some of the rerolls are great, but obviously starting with Ipecac is going to give you basically everything that you need. Check out the room here. By room, I mean the store, of course. Oh, pin. Oh, buddy. Yep. Down goes pin. I mean, you know, when powerful, why not get more powerful? We get Brimstone, Tech X, Ipecac, Sumptorium. It's pretty good. I have a bomb. You would think that with all this explosive power, we would have a way to get into the curse room, but we don't. Yeah. This is how we like to say in the biz, muy bueno. They're looking for a decent reroll here. Chemical Peel is not going to do it. Belly Jelly, nah. We already have explosive shots. Don't really need any of that. Oh! Hey, you can't get mad at me for not taking Soy Milk. The game literally took it away from us. I would have 100% taken Soy Milk. 1,000,000% have taken Soy Milk. Like, because it's just, it would be constant explosions. In fact, Soy Milk might actually be extremely dangerous with this build, but at the same time, man. Of all the items, why did it have to take Soy Milk away from us? Because I was ready for it, man. I mean, that's just a fun time waiting to happen right there. Okay. Oh, we hit the mushroom that was next to us, of course. Exploded up into a bad gas. Okay, gulp. Well, we gulped the pay to win trinket, so we get a health up. Virgo's been killing it for us, too. Everything has been killing it for us in this run. Everything. And in turn, we're killing everything. That goes Chubb. Get the matchbook, which gives us basically nothing. And that Eternal Art's going to be useful as well. Sure, Mama Victa's okay. Mama Victa, if she was watching this run, she'd be like, is this how all the Isaac runs go? Like, no. Not how all the Isaac runs go. This is a freak anomaly. A unicorn of a run here we got. This is not a combo you see a lot of. This Ipecac, Brimstone, Tech X run, Sumptorium. Sumptorium being like probably the biggest part of all this, because obviously Sumptorium is what makes this build so powerful. Like, just the layering upon layering of shots is just insane. And then we get the cancer item, which is, oh boy, that's just gonna add to the pain. So cancer is going to give us the wafer effect, which halves all damage every time we take damage. So for the room that we're currently in, if we take any damage, whether it's self-inflicted or not, for the rest of our duration in that room, we will take half damage. And that just makes this run even more ridiculous than it already is. Now imagine if we get Guppy. Lump of Coal, which is also kind of insane. I mean, this run is—it's almost sad, honestly. It really is almost sad because the game is not going to be able to do anything. Like, this is the type of run that you want for like unlocks and stuff. Apparently, the science infection tears do explode. So I learned something new today. We don't need to go in the store. And I mean, there's literally no reason why we can't just be using soul hearts here, because like we don't need HP. It's not that HP isn't important, of course, but when the game can't do any damage to you, it really doesn't matter how much HP you have. It just comes down to how much HP are you taking away from yourself? No, it's there's no reason to do that. This run is way too dominant, way too much fun, just absolutely yeeting, and I mean truly yeeting this game. You have to enunciate the T when you say yeeting. Whenever it's like, you know. You can't just say like we're yeeting this game right now. Like no. You have to really put your back into it. We're yeeting this game right now. Analog stick is just gonna give us a multi-directional shot, which we didn't really even need anyway, but you know. Hey, it's glad you're here. I mean, I'm glad you're here, you know. No, the mosh pit's glad you're here. We care about you, analog stick, you know. You may be totally irrelevant in this run. But, you know, that doesn't mean that we can't appreciate what you do for the team. Get down here real quick because it might be our item room. It's not. Only one item away from Guppy as well, which would be kind of cool if we got it, but if we don't, I don't think it's that big of a deal, to be honest. Get the Bookworm transformation. So we're just going to be firing even more tiers. We also got the Book of Virtues. And hey, look at that, a full health pill. Gears up. Come on, man. It's holding up production here. Oh, my God. We shouldn't be doing that because it's going to kill our tiers rate, and there's literally no reason to, but you know what? We took it anyway. We've got quad shot, so, you know, just going to be even more tiers streaming down the screen. And can you even really call them tiers anymore? Because I don't think I can. Not with a straight face anyway. These are waves. These are rings of death that we're firing here. This is beyond domination of the game at this point. Now goes Mom. She didn't even get a foot down. Oh, you know we're taking our talents to South Beach, but also to Delirium. Sure, I guess. And let's just beat Boss Rush for the hell of it. But like, just imagine what Soy Milk would have done for this run. Like, seriously. I mean, we're firing Funyuns is what we're doing. We're just firing giant Funyuns. There we go. That's how you beat Boss Rush in the Binding of Isaac. Fairly difficult task sometimes, but you know. You can manage it. That's how you do it. And like, we could pick up some more of the money or whatever for Money Goes Power, but we got to beat. We've got a mega stand to kill here. Got to be to the southeast. There's no way that they're gonna make you travel that far and have the boss not be down there, right? Right. Right. We're probably at the Sumptorium cap. I had to guess, but I'm still gonna use it just because. Spencer, even on a winning run, you're still not welcome. This is a little bit of a conundrum. I'm going to say to the west, maybe. Maybe? Of course not. What moron would think would be to the west? That is kind of hilarious how the sinus infection tears will explode after a while. Not over here either. So it's literally on none of them. The answer is nowhere in the west. Going to the east. It ain't south and it ain't north. I can guarantee that. And if any Claudies should fall for some odd reason, well, then we don't have to worry about replenishing them because we're going to get them back. And as we get purity here, Looking for more soul hearts here. Didn't really mean to kill Gabriel, but you know what? Yeah, sure, we can go fight Hush again. Why not? You know, there's no rule that says we can't beat Hush twice. Old Hushy. He got spanked so hard the first time that we don't think that we did the we didn't do a good enough job the first time. So we're gonna bring it back here. Getting leech is actually kind of hilarious. That's gonna heal us. As if we needed anything else in this run, the ability to heal our red hearts is definitely something that we could stand to gain from. Speed up here. Already pretty full speed. We've been full speed for a while, so we're not going to get Guppy. Not that I think it really matters, of course, but Blue Baby was, he was hit so hard against the back wall, he actually came towards us. No cloddy death this time for you, Hush. Okay, maybe one or two. Yeah. And to be honest, we don't even need this many clots to do that many shots. Like, we have that many tiers without, like, 4 billion Clotties because we've got Quad Shot and Conjoined. So the fact that we're, like, still using Sumptorium is kind of extra. But I'm still going to do it. And I think now is a good time to ask today's question of the episode. I think that it's a fair question of, brought from an unbiased source, but... Give me your thoughts on Sumptorium, on the whole. I don't remember if we've asked the opinion about Sumptorium before. I feel like we may have. I don't remember if that was a question of the episode or not, but do you think it's a boring item? Do you think it's a strong item? Is it an item that's too risky for you to use? Let me know in the comments. I'd love to hear your thoughts on it. Because for me personally, I think Sumptorium is a must-have. My love of Sumptorium has been well documented and well known for a while now. And in case if I have already asked that question for a question of the episode, then what's your take on Ipecac? If I've asked this Sumptorium question before, we've already gotten to that point where I don't remember if I have or not. What's your take on Ipecac? Is Ipecac an item that you always take? Is it an item that you have to kind of give a little bit of pause to? Or is it a, you know, we always take Ipecac? Ipecac's just automatic pickup, automatic win, no matter the risk. Post it in the comments. So there you go. You have two flavors of options. Of course, the top three comments will be read next week, next Tuesday's run. Thank you for supporting the channel, everybody out there as well. I hope your Tuesdays are great. I don't know if we're going to be fighting Delirium or not. Not that it really matters. Stanley is just going to kind of do whatever he wants. How much HP you got? Oh, you're over here. Blasting Stanley right in the face with the Ipecac Pec-X Brimstone shots. And we're going to go fight Delirium, so it ain't done yet. Gonna use telepills because hell, why not? And it took us one room away from where we started. You telepills. I mean, when things take longer to do their death animation and die rather than like fight, you know you're in good. This has to be Delirium over here. I refuse to believe that the game would bring us all this way to give us nothing here. A little nice little heal by Leech there. Telepills again. It's not Delirium, it's Isaac. battery pack, which is like probably the lamest thing that could ever drop from a void boss. Those things just died immediately. I didn't even like join the room. Where are we? Oh man, we got teleport way down there. Okay. Now we do need to keep some HP for Delirium, because I definitely don't feel like fighting him on one HP. Of course, Delirium's not over here. Why would Delirium be over here? That's asinine. Why would you think that? Of course, Delirium's over here. My God, the amount of explosions that go off whenever we just hit a simple steel block in the environment is absurd. And remember, we've got the wafer effect from the cancer item, so when I say there's a 0% chance that we lose this run, it's a 0% chance, an absolute zero. Even if we somehow lose this life, as we continue to chase Delirium around and around, even if we somehow manage to lose this life and go down to 1 HP, we still are going to have 2 hits against Delirium. Oh, wait, we can't bomb our way through board. And even then, with Leech here, Leech loves to kill Delirium as, and he can just heal us up from that. So, yeah. There's an absolute 0% chance that we lose this run. Not even Delirium's buggy face can do this. So bring all your BS, Delirium, because it's not going to matter. None of this will matter. We can basically just bully Delirium in his own room by shoving him back. So that's the rare black Delirium that you just saw there on Steven. Every now and then, Delirium's sprite will glitch out and he'll turn black. Down he goes. Man, oh man, what an absolutely dominant run. From the moment we could see our HP to the moment we got Delirium kicked right in the pants, we absolutely destroyed this run. Thank you for watching, everyone. If you enjoyed this episode, make sure you click the like button. Leave a comment down below for that explosive and entertaining run as we make our way towards the next life streak goal. Only need 9 more on the tally, so definitely click that like button. Leave a comment down below. Remember, today's question of the episode, what is your take on Sumptorium? And if I've already asked that one, then what is your take on Ipecac? Are either one of those items good enough for you to take every single time? Are they too risky? Post them in the comments. I love to hear the divergent strategies involving all these items in the game. That's what makes Isaac so great. And as always, I'll see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody. Thanks for watching this video. I'd like to thank some patrons of mine like Katie Bobady, Cody DeMatteis, and Nicholas. If you'd like to have your name read at the end of an Isaac episode, check out my Patreon campaign, which you can find over at patreon.com/Sinvicta.